inventive study on things, monology, monosophy, and sense value study group. Hiroshi conducts research on Japanese ideas of nature, humanity, and religion, and explores the way they can be relevant to contemporary art. Today's lecture is entitled Media Art as a Medium, which is a very interesting thing, and then there's an interesting object he's working here. He's going to talk about in this lecture. So in this lecture, he or she will discuss his work that informs Japanese cultural specificity, but also addresses transnational possibilities. His recent work has been produced as an international project called Utsuwa, Utsushi. These are two Japanese terminology. Utsuwa means receptacle or vessel or vacuum. Reality, there are many meanings in level up of abstract to very tangible meaning. And Utsushi is a copy or transfer or possessed. Again, there's a layers of meaning attached to this Japanese terminology. But this project called Utsuwa Utsushi, he's conducting as a project leader. And this is a very large international project initiated by Professor Inaga Shigemi, who is an eminent art historian and Deputy Director General of International Research Center for Japanese Studies in Kyoto. And then luckily we have him present here. So after lecture, probably we can have a joint discussions on this project. So this was funded by the Japanese government in 2016. And since then, it developed into the current international project involving UAL and myself and Toshio from TrAIN and designer maker Maiko Tsutsumi, teaching at Camberwell College. And also we involve some ceramic artists from Japan and also archaeologists and curators from University of Oxford. So this is a very interdisciplinary project involving practitioners and archaeologists and art historians. Inspired by Inaga's initial art historical inquiry proposing a pirate's view of world history, and also drawing from wordplay of two etymologically associated Japanese terminology, utsuwa and utsushi, this project raises philosophical and visual cultural questions on the conventional idea of dichotomy, original versus copy, fine art versus applied art, seen versus unseen, and material versus immaterial. So there are very different levels of inquiries in this project. The current rigid legal regulations and knowledge production system set by global powers have been challenged by the pirate trade, and idea of copy also enables us to realize the positive values that can be found in Japanese and East Asian ideas. The project members, including Hiroshi, with different expertise and disciplines, explore positive values and meaning of copy, leading to an alternative idea of knowledge in the 21st century. And we are expecting a series of workshops, exhibitions, and symposium as an outcome of this project, and that are planned in 2018 in the UK. So please welcome Hiroshi.
Thank you. Hello, nice to meet you. I'm Hiroshi Onishi from Japan. I'm very glad because today is a You understand my English? Okay. Thank you. Okay, let's go. This is a today's menu. The first chapter is spirituality in major technologies of Japan. It will be good for understanding second chapter. Second chapter is today's main topic. I will explain my artwork, Shrine Fish, JLG, and Shrine Fish, Lumiere. Shrine Fish, Lumiere, it is here. I put on the desk table. Please watch the project. And last chapter is our new project. Chapter 1. I will use some words from Parisian. It may not be the typical style for this presentation. However, I think it's good for understanding the core of media art. First is photographs, about photographs. How to capture the natural images? It was the first issue of the modern media technologies. This is one of the first photograph process technology. It named daguerreotype, invented by This is a typical photograph image of daguerreotype. Daguerreotype was introduced in Japan by Prof. Do you know Prof? Japanese student, of course, now, in fact, Japanese student, you know. When I gave some same question to my foreign student, they imagined Profne is a name of a man. Profne sounds Kurosawa and Mifune mixture. Do you know those people? There are many very famous film makers in Japan, but little bit old. It's wrong. Profune is not name of man. Profune is a battleship of USA. Kuro means black and fune means ship in Japanese. This picture painted in 1855. It was the end of the Tokugawa period. Have you ever seen this picture? It's so scary. Laser beam and demon coming to Japan. Edo-period Japanese people thought that it's so scary experiment of Japan. Maybe. This picture painted in 1854. Perry's crew. Perry is battleship's captain of battleship. Perry's crew took photos of geisha girls for president of USA. President likes Utsuwa maybe. This is picture painted in 1861. It was the end of the Tokugawa period. Many foreign photographers came and took photos in Japan. This is a French photographer's picture. And this picture painted in 1875, beginning of Meiji period. Japanese people learned photograph techniques from foreign photographers, then became local photographers. Amblotype, which is one of the photographic process, it was popular in Meiji period Japan. Amblotype needed to set into the box. If we see them without box, we see negative images. So put black paper under the photograph, then put write kiribako. It means all paronia root case. This is paronia. Kiri has, paronia has those functions, right? Strong, heat resistant, and highly breathable. So kiri used for many products, sandals, koto. Koto is one of the instrumental for all Japanese music. And as, how can I say in English? As is a kato, a kapo, something. Also kome, miso, and last one is stove, kabao stove, and center is no clay mask. Everything made from kiri. All Japanese people, the function of kiri are not limited to them. Japanese people believe kiri is the holy wood. The phoenix lives in it. It is a symbol of good fortune. Kiri and phoenix on the Ramma. Ramma is phoenix song, decoration above line. And kiri and phoenix on pan for mockery. There are many kiri and phoenix Japanese art. And kiri wood chest of drawers for bride. Parents gives it their daughter when she married. It's so expensive. Maybe over 1 million yen. What is that? Ivan? That's right. coffee, most high class coffee. When I gave the same question, my student from abroad, they could also answer. And they interested in this design.
Door. Why Japanese coffee put door and open?
I don't know, but it's very unique. It's very unique for in the world. Someone knows the reason, please tell me after this lecture. Okay, so work is of, so artwork is often put into kiribako. Paulonia would face in Japan. Artwork in kiribako, there are typical styles in Japan. There are many artwork in kiribako. And kiribako has calligraphy inside or outside. There are autographs of artists and explanation of history about the artwork. For comparing the number of types, the Western Japan.
Japanese people write kiri, or it's used kiri wood. But the Western people, I don't know that material.
Probably if the material has some reason, please tell me after this lecture. A few decades later, Japanese photograph culture made an interesting superstition. If take a photo of three persons, the center will be dark skin. people understood that taking a photo, capturing image, is capturing both. So Japanese photo studio set a door for both parts. You see, this is the door for both parts. And this same as Japanese people of the time thought that photograph could take the soul ghost along with the image. Next, moving image. Japanese people are interested in watching the kage. Kage means shadow and silhouette. This picture drawn by Hokusai, Katsushika Hokusai, in Hokusai manga, or Hokusai sketch, beginning of 19th century. Silhouette of Mountain Fuji, Mount Fuji appeared on Shoji. Shoji is a screen paper slide door.
There is a small pinhole, and camera obscura, natural camera obscura.
And Japanese people feel soul. Japanese people feel soul from kage. Kage is not copy. Kage has own something.
And this, there are many kage pictures.
Also, Japanese people are interested in watching and viewing the landscape through from the window. Window captures the landscape like a cinema screen. Screening of cinematography in Japan. This is a picture. Cinematography of Japanese based on watching the silhouette and watching the landscape from the window. This is a cinematography in Osaka, Japan. Beginning of 20th century. And this is a photography theater area in Ueno, Tokyo, Japan. Middle, minimal, 20th century. during the time of Japan, but the denwa sen, telephone network line is so nice. Telegraph poles, it's called denchu in Japan, Nagata-cho in 1899. The denwa sen, telephone line was the subject of the painting. And this is Sugoroku, Japanese backgammon. Japanese people were glad to see line. Lines. But nowadays, there are nuisance of city landscape. But Japanese people continue to write network lines. This is a Kyoto painting of ghost in jail. Mamoru Oshi directed this animation film in 1995, and Hollywood remade this in this year. And Japanese people felt mysterious something about transportation of the boys. The boys' transportation was also subject of painting. Telephone network system was so spiritual and holy for Japanese people, so it was the best place on the house during Showa period. Nowadays, desktop phone is almost extinction. Radio. Japanese people felt mysterious something for transportation of the voice of radio broadcasting, radio broadcasting. It was same as telephone network in this case. Antenna was only symbol. And the radio receiver was also mysterious and holy. It brought the voice from the air. People felt spirituality from the radio voice. This is the first Japanese-made crystal radio receiver, 1925. I think headset is important to feel spirituality because it makes listener concentrate to the voice and separate from the real world. Listening to crystal radio. Japanese kids love late night broadcasting. Late night is most spiritual time zone. There is one more spiritual thing in the radio. It is capturing the voice from the air. Searching for a channel is like the shaman channeling. So the device became that interface of another world is video. Next, television and video. The television is same as the radio. It brings moving image and voice from the air. This picture is the TV's first public release in Japan at Mitsubishi department store. Meaning of that was not personal meaning. In 60s, it was into the home. After parents went to bed, it became a personal media for kids. So Japanese kids could communicate with spirits, demon, and God. Television receiver became the interface of another world as media. This manga is television. It means TV boy. Made by Shigeru Mizuki, who was a famous manga artist in Japan. He was a soldier in World War II. He had explained that This is a painting of Japanese popular ghost story, Utsuwa Kaiga. It may be based on the same idea that the device becomes the interface of another world, as magic. The lantern was modern technology in Edo period. Videotape recorder added another spiritual thing to television. It was capturing moving image. This is mean that we can capture spirits, demons, and gods, then distribute them. This film was made by this idea, The Ring, 1998. Have you ever seen this movie film? The Ring, you know? It's so scary. So I can't watch completely, part by part. I watch. But today, I will show you. This is a captured ghost in the video tape in the ring. If you don't like scary movie, please see other side. Let's go. Coming to this about the computer technology of media. Characteristic of computer age is appeared in the room of PC otaku. Otaku means enthusiast. They collect many digital devices, gadgets, and make own sacred place. It's the place of worship for them. But sometimes their mother or wife disturbs their worship. Room of PC otaku in 2000. And this is my workspace in 2004. Unfortunately, I was not an otaku. I had no enough money and passion to be otaku. Especially, modem has a spirituality. We felt the spirit from modem sound and ringing lamp. How many people know this device, modem? Thank you. Young people don't know, of course. Okay, we try to listen this sound for adult person. Digital device become the interface for another world as medium. When we connecting the server and downloading data, the attractive of Ghost in the Shell is based on like this same idea. It is not only science fiction in cyberspace. It has many spiritual ideas. Many people know watched this film. Oh, thank you. How you do made this this year? Oshi Mamoru, who is the original animation film director, said new Hollywood.
In the near future, corporate networks reach out to the stars, and electrons and light flow throughout the universe. The advance of computerization, however, has not yet wiped out nations and ethnic groups.
Thank you. virtual experience mean then?
Well, all your memories about your wife and your daughter are false, and are more like a dream. You've been taken advantage of by someone, and we're trying to do a ghost hack on some government officials.
Oh God, it can't be.
I've been to your apartment. No one. A bachelor room.
I told you I rented that room when we were separated.
You've been living in that room for over 10 years now.
My code name is Project 2501. And I am a life form that was born in a sea of information.
This is my provide for them. It is better to invite them to the Yashiro. Yashiro means shrine. What is a holy house for a witch is a holy house for God. Ghost. Buddha. Spirituals. Ancestors. But typical shrines are too big to have inside or home. So I use the portable shrine, which is called Utsushi, like this. This is a reason for the appearance of my work. Shrine fish, JLG, is for ghost of history to cinema by Jan Rikota. This film is a ghost of legacy films because JLG cut many old films and made the film of courage, like the Frankenstein monster. I think that JLG exchanged radio message with many legacy films as a medium for Shaman. So he is one of the media artists. Giant fish Lumiere. For explaining, I made a short film, but it's only Japanese subtitles, so I try to explain in English, but maybe I can. Japan decided to homeless them and give them as offering to the shrine. This time I choose a portable shrine for mobility. That is real media art. Ghosts of the past cinema exist around us, and they are increasing now. So I decided to give them as an offering to the shrine. And maybe I should explain why the goldfish. I think that goldfish is the same as a moving image on media. It was captured then edited and copied many times, and now no one knows the original anymore. The original living of the fish of my artwork is no longer in the real world. It has passed away and been buried in a common river in Tokyo. So the moving image of goldfish becomes the original. Chapter 3 is the last chapter. I would introduce past Utsuwa's project. We have an exhibition and a conference in Paris in 2015. Many researchers and artists gathered in Paris and discuss about Utsuwa. The center of the center of this photograph is Professor Inaga. He is the leader of this research project, and he is here today. There are over 3 persons in this photo, so don't worry, Dr. Inaga. This is lecture conference, and also this, and this is the exhibition part. This is an exhibition to 2015 in Tokyo. Artists try to appear to have seen their artworks. And Japanese style discussing Chakai. Chakai means this. Show you some example about Utsuwa, Utsushi. This example is taking a picture in the anime, Shashin of Utsu. Shashin of Utsu. Shashin is a picture or composition like to Utsu from a form of Utsushi. It's take. She is not only taking, but she has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 means. It can be character, can explain that those. So she has many means, taking, shooting, reproduction, copy, project, projection, moving, transporting, bringing, infection, etc. Another example of Utsushi. Artists in Japanese traditional art often try to make Utsushi. Right image is original Receptacle by Chojo, and left is Utsushi of Chojo. Utsushi means copy? No. Utsushi. no hierarchical structure of file, original and copy. What does this transport? It may material things, technical things, spiritual things, and also things. We remember the superstition of photograph, which is also based on the same idea. Another example of shadow, shadow, silhouette, project shadow, kage o utsushi, kage shadow, or reproduction utsushi in this project. And the word project includes another means, creative utsushi. It's not only project. All of the system in connected relation. And another example of the system, koe. Koe of this transport. And another example of the system, ezo, image, ezo of this, utsushi and this. Moving image was is transported and projected. Another example of utsushi, data of transport and copy, and also download. Another example of utsushi, human being, transport and copy, it's like closing shape. And what is Utsuwa? Utsuwa has also unique images. Yes, unique images. I think that the process nuance is medium of media. Both in the cell tells us what is just a media, also content and network. This is a fundamental media, Utsuwa. Of moving image, it's around the world. It's not only Japanese. A project was launched in London and Oxford in 2018. Like that. Please look forward to it. And this is a country member, project member. The Oxford team. They had Anagama Kiru. There is one anthropologist, Dr. Robin Wilson, and Issa Kazuya.
I think word play is not only Japanese. For example, the Western word has one word, anima. Anima has been something like energy. Anima is one of the original anima chain to animation, animal, animus, blah blah blah. All of the words has same in Utsushi language. Is that how is my experience? I have one idea. Professor Inaga explain well.
Can I invite Professor Inaga to
please
this Mr. Onishi's talk with your idea of pirate's view, pirate's view of the world?
I'm not quite sure if it's the appropriate moment for me to intervene. Rather, I really want to hear, listen to the reaction from the audience. Because the framework of the discussion was clearly explained already by Professor Kikuchi at the beginning of this lecture. And there are several hints and images and the idea of the polonia for the first time, and polonia has something quite holy and in the East Asian culture sphere, and it has used, for example, in coffee making. And how would be the reactions of the audience this evening? How would be it would be very interesting. And this would be the first one, and probably secondary. Yeah, I know. The idea of shrine came from coffin and shrine, and these boxes are very important for Onishi-san and in his production, and how to handle the intangible images and data and the electronicity and so on and so forth. This would be the second, and probably there are reactions among the audience on that. And thirdly, of course, there's many word plays. In the notion of Utsushi, this is transport and transportation, and also Utsuwa, it was the vessel, so coffin was also box, and boxes was a vessel, and how to put the electricity or the material, immaterial things in all kind of boxes, and which comes back to the shrine, and how it would be the association, the images that you can develop from that. So I'm really eager to hear your reactions, and it will be the beginning of the conversation, I think. Right?
Yeah, okay, so any comment or reactions, which part of this presentation really interests you, probably the good starting point for discussions? Anybody?
Hello, this is a very interesting talk. I guess it's more like a semi-comments or kind of question too. You talk about spirituality by looking at this kind of media archaeology, sort of. So I'm wondering, how does materiality figure in your kind of research? Because what you look at is also the materials, right? By looking at all these kind of gadgets, the technology. So how does the spirituality and materiality play in your project and in your kind of mapping? Thank you.
Already, there had a relation my student from abroad said to me, what is materiality? Materiality, they focus on material during their art watching. But we guys don't care about the material. Material is included to spirituality already. How can I say English? It's difficult for me explain in English. How do you feel my answer?
Understand?
Really?
Probably it's paraphrased like a reading spirituality in kind of real.
Thank you.
Is there any particular material that you can find some spiritual meaning in your, like, if you are a practitioner? Do you have an example?
It's really interesting presentation. I really like how you put connect between spirituality and also like a material, like three-dimensional material, let's say human production. My question is that do you think that this spirituality that emerge in our daily device, technology or medium, if you say it, so. Do you think that this spirituality could increase the similarity between us human and also the medium itself or technology? Let's say with the current issue, it's artificial intelligence, for example. Thank you.
The important spirituality artifact.
Probably, yes.
Could you like elaborate a little bit more, like why do you think it's possible, and then how do you see this spirituality, let's say, in the next 10 years?
Spirituality. It depends on human race. I think we should be more spiritual because material is so tired. I don't like that. I feel sun from window, voice from snow. Atmosphere from space, universe, is so relaxed. We need the gas. Nowadays, in countries, everyone needs spirituality, I think. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Thank you. Stop the mask, guy.
Is that something you say that the human beings in general need more spirituality in this artificial environment?
Yeah, I mean, like, do you think that this spirituality maybe it's the main device to really increase the speed of let's say singularity between the technology and us as human? I'm like right now. Our concern is about like, should we increase the process, because we still think that there's a huge gap between us and technology. I'm like, we are the one who create this technology, but we felt that there's still a gap, that this gap may be because
control this technology or the medium, or maybe our own concern about maybe medium will control us, or maybe because the spirituality, perhaps we already in control of this medium, because through this, let's say, medium that don't have soul, but then we felt like this connection of spirituality emerged from this medium. So I think that relationship is really interesting.
I think so. Japanese, my friend, I shown a picture, Kondo, Mr. Kondo, said, same as he is a ceramic artist, he used clay and fire, but he can't control them. But it's not bad. He inspired from uncontrollable things. It is one of his creation. Is it okay?
Michael, because it's more of that from designer maker's point of view that can relate to Kondo-san's case.
I was just thinking about how you are talking from the viewpoint of a Japanese person, and partly I can relate, but partly I guess it's slightly alien to me as well, as a concept. But what I do really agree is that this relationship between materiality and spirituality in Japan, and that is kind of deeply embedded in our everyday lives and, you know, beliefs and everything. But when it comes to technology, I can see the point you're trying to make about spirituality in technology, or maybe technology in the history, you know, in Japan, is seen as something slightly, you know, something that carries spiritual element. But I don't think everyone sees it in that way. And but in a way, like your question about how we might carry on kind of developing more technological world, you know, in for human race in general, and with the feeling that we feel like technology is still the other side, of the opposite of human, and how, where are we going to go with this? You know, are we going to increase that spirituality in technology, or that we are coming back to more human, you know, based kind of way of doing things, like Mr. Kondo working with clay? So I guess your question was that, how, you know, and I would like to know how you see it, you know. That's what I was thinking when I was hearing other people's questions, because it's really a complicated subject, isn't it? And I'm very much conscious of how your work and your viewpoints could be shared by many others, you know, who are not coming from the same context of Japanese culture, because spirituality and materiality means very differently to them. Not just meaning, but like they experience it very differently. So that's kind of my thinking.
そうですね。それを堤さんはどうですか？
my English skill is not enough to discuss about it. But how can I say? Japanese語で考えて言おうとしたことを英語で言おうとすると忘れますね。 で、言おうとしたことも忘れた。ごめんなさいね、 sorry in Japanese only. This technology is not perfect. It's beginning of this beginning of changing my our thinking philosophy. I think this.
I had a question, more of a comment, I guess. Thank you very much for your presentation. I thought it was very clear and laid out some really interesting points about the relationship between materiality and spirituality and technology. I wanted to come back really to the point, the discussion that's been made around the relationship between spirituality and materiality, and just think about that in relation to contemporary art, which is what I'm interested in. And in a way, I think this question of spirituality in relation to art now, at this moment, is a very interesting time to have that conversation in a transnational context. Because it's interesting that, for example, why I say that is because there are some ways in which the way that some contemporary artists are engaging with technology relates to elements of spirituality, but it's not necessarily put in terms of spirituality or religion. It's often put in terms of thinking about the animation of objects, or the way that objects have a kind of another life, which somehow transcends, you know, bodily functions, or it might to do even ideas around magic is also quite current in some contemporary art circles. And it feels as though we've come full circle from early modernism, the early 20th century, like abstract painting, for example, which was often driven by discussions around spirituality, right? So people like Kandinsky wrote texts on the spirituality in art, and then that went completely out of fashion. No one talked about spirituality. But it's interesting now that through this kind of concern about technology and the fact that technology were out of control, there seems to be more and more people talking about immateriality and a sense of something which is otherworldly. So it's not put exactly in the term that you're talking about, spirituality related to a it's more put in terms of a sense of being beyond human understanding and control. So for example, the kind of algorithmic universe that we're living in, where this idea that machines are developing forms of intelligence that we don't understand, that is taking the function of God in a way, means that I think this time now, I think you're raising these questions at a time when I think there could be a really interesting cross-cultural, transnational dialogue about what the relationship between materiality and spirituality or immateriality could be. That was just really a commentary on your talk, so thank you.
Thank you very much. Sorry, my English skills.
It was a comment, so that I have to ask your question.
Thank you very much. But I want to pick up on Paul's point and ask a question that way, if you see what I mean. So we're engaging. Do you think that that transnational dialogue is empowered by technology which has this kind of opportunity to break outside of the hegemonies of kind of Western control of art, for example? Do you think that's a positive thing, or do you think that it's just this kind of the spirituality we're talking about here is so vague and kind of unknowing that there's not much to actually get hold of? So is this a positive thing or a negative thing in very crude terms, but is the question. And then I guess that kind of comes back to thinking about the depth of some of the stuff you've talked about, particularly right at the very beginning, the boxes you talked about with those photographs that were in, the depth of the material and what that material meant was really quite significant, quite kind of tangible. It felt like you could get hold of, you could understand what that was. Maybe what we're talking about now, this kind of rather loose idea of spirituality, is a bit vague and unknowing. Sorry, it's a bit vague, but
just very quickly, I'll let Professor Onishi reply. I think it's a good thing. I do think that some of the ways that we in the West are understanding the debate about technology and spirituality is coming through Japanese in the East Asian cultures, in visual popular culture, through manga, for example. So the example, the influence of Ghost in the Shell, the movies, the comics, etc., is very popular in, I think, a lot of the younger artists, contemporary artists, are looking at that imagery and that kind of depictions of a kind of technological dystopia that is coming out of a specifically Japanese context, but which obviously has been kind of, there are dangers to that, because sometimes, as we can see, you know, the imagery in the Hollywood becomes whitewashed. So they use a white actress to play an Asian character, or sometimes a specific cultural understanding that, for example, Professor Onishi talks about, the link to Japanese spiritual traditions is not present in the way it translates transnationally. So I think Professor Professor Onishi's project, and also a project next year in London and Oxford, is important to reintroduce the context, the cultural context of where some of these discussions are coming from. Because within the kind of contemporary art sphere, there's a very ahistorical, acultural, and therefore very Western dominated discourse, which I think, you know, can be a problem.
Thank you. I understand.
Just to return to Paronia tree, just one anecdote which is quite famous. How many of you have already read Yuko Kikuchi written by Okakura? and some of the chapters are still included in one in the anthology of art theory, not only on East Asia but also in the West. And several years ago, one extract of the passage was included in the kind of anthology. And there's a very famous anecdote of the paulownia tree, which was cut down and made, the people made from the tree a kind of instrument, musical instrument. And how to attune, how to listen to the spirit of that paulownia tree, and there's a secret in a sense for it. It's a very beautiful passage on that, and I really strongly recommend you to read it through. I keep it in secret. I can't repeat the passage, but it's so beautiful and so musical, which was written by the Japanese already 120 years ago. This is one thing. And to finish in connection with that, the old tools which are broken, and in our culture, we cannot throw it away easily, because if you use a tool for 100 years, it has its own spirit. And we can imagine quite easily, because a competitor uses his beloved tool for a long time, his experience is already embedded in a tool. So it's part of his body, it's part of his métier, it's part of his, his technology is in that tool, and he shares his own experience with that instrument, which is so familiar and so intimate to him. And how can one throw it away when it's broken? And how to reutilize it? And this is probably the beginning of the conversation with the spirituality through materiality. And there is that kind of connection, and separating the technology from human body is, and also materiality, is not really rational. And we really have to find out a good way to go into the spirituality. And just in an etymological way, and I conclude with that. Yeah, of course, Onishi-sensei talked about anima, which comes from Aristotle, and it's worth reading. And also in biblical connection, pneuma in Greek was translated in aura, and aura is very famous in the thesis of Walter Benjamin on the reproduction. But how aura and pneuma? These are the breath. And if it's holy spirit comes from Hagia Pneuma. So in Christian tradition, in Bible tradition, that spirituality felt through the materiality and through the vibration of the air and communication. And there are that kind of metaphor everywhere. And this is not the monopoly of the so-called Oriental culture. So this is also another key to make a transnational conversation on the spirituality. So this is only the beginning, but I think there's a very fecund field of research which we have to investigate. Thanks so much.
Thank you very much, Professor Inaga, to conclude, and then gave us more suggestions for transnational dialogue. And thank you very much, Professor Onishi, for inspiring lots of questions.